Hearing God's word, Romans chapter 10, verse 17. The opposite of faith is fear. How does fear come? By hearing the word of the devil. There are people who already say something cannot be done. That is negative. Anything that is negative kills faith. Anything that is positive increases faith. Fear comes by hearing negative reports. They told Moses, 12 spies were sent, and they came back and said, 2 said, we are able to conquer. 10 said, we are like grasshoppers. They called themselves grasshoppers. The giant didn't call them to. They saw themselves as grasshoppers. So we are not able to conquer these people, for they are giants. 2 said, we are able. Somebody say, we are able. No, you didn't shout it. So who you listen to determine what you become. So faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God, hearing the right word. If you listen to people who say there's no God, you will soon become godless. So don't listen to all the scientific definitions and demonic teachings or movie that swayed you. Some of you just watch only movie, and you are using movie lifestyle to want to control your lifestyle. You want to live the lifestyle of those superstars. Not unknown to you that you are living a fake life, because what you are seeing in the movie is a fake life. It's not reality. One woman was watching a movie one day, and she told her, see the way the man is doing with the wife, you know, they're just hanging out, everything just romantic, they are just enjoying their life. The man said, that's not reality of life, bro. That's movie, my friend.
That's movie.
Face reality. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
That's reality. That's reality is different from movie. See, they are just talking, they are just going out, they are just buying, just drinking. Said, can we live like this? The man said, look, my friend, you want to face reality? There's no time for all this unfair. This was, do you see them any day one go doing something serious? From one clip of movie to another clip, to another, they just showing spots of their romantic moment. You think that's how they are living? The ones they remove, did you know what is happening with that one? Say face reality. Touch your neighbor, say face reality. Face reality. You see them kiss every second in the movies. Kiss, kiss. You say, oh, my husband doesn't kiss me like this. My husband is not romantic. African men are not romantic. Listen to me. If he's not romantic, use yourself. Try to be romantic. Any day I'm like human being and I kiss my wife, she say, where did that come from? I say, from me, of course. Where should it come from me? She say, oh, may we be seeing this thing like this? Oh, I say, amen. But every day is not Christmas. Because I'm not in the flesh every day. Face reality. You are married this one already. You are married spirit and man. And when she finished talking, I say, I'm a good man. He say, I know you will praise yourself. I say, I'm a good man. He say, yes. He say, what about you? I say, you're a good woman. But face reality. You can have him 24/7. I was here like 10 years ago after prayer line. He said, please come home and eat. Then my mother in law took off. Are you coming home now? I say, I'm on my way. He says, since morning. I know what they are saying. Because by the time you get home, you are no more a human being. You jump on the bed, boom, like a log of wood. They say, honey, I say, I'm tired. Sorry. It will get better someday.
Amen.
When Jesus comes.
If you listen to failures, you will end up as a failure.
Yes, true.
Listen to right people. Faith coming by hearing. Wife, obey thy husband. Husband, love thy wife. Don't try to compare your husband with another man. You will soon lose him. Don't try to compare your children with another person's children. You will not have them. you want to grow in faith and you are working with pastor who say fasting is not necessary.
Yes.
You have killed your ministry. Fasting is important in ministry and life. For man shall not live by bread alone. Americans, you guys eat too much. I was in for a meeting this morning, for a breakfast meeting, and they were all drinking all kind of pudding. Even I only take sweet tea because I don't want to look foolish among them. So they'll say, give me. I don't even know what to order. The paper, everything, there was too much on the book. Is it Evans Bob, right?
Yeah, Evans.
Bob Evans.
Bob Evans. Well, Evans, Bob, Bob Evans. Anything Bob. Evangelist Bob. They were eating. I said, what is this? Say, just give me that black thing. They say, what's that? They say, it's sweet. I said, let me just drink it. See, you don't eat. It's too early to eat. All these gallons you are eating is too early to eat. At night, you are eating all this. I didn't say you should not eat you because I'm eating now. Praise the Lord. I'm eating. I mean, today I've eaten in the office. And I want to eat more. Look big. So when I'm entering the door, people will say, that's the man of God. This one, I look like a boy of God. Understand, as we conclude this subject, nature hates vacuum. Nature hates what?
Vacuum.
Nature hates emptiness. Jesus said when a demon is casted out, just one demon, and he goes, because it was casted out, when he returns, they will always come back to check. Demons don't go forever. When they go, they always come back to check. That's a principle. And so that's why in the miraculous ministry, when you heal certain cases and such people get in and they leave the ministry, the sickness comes back. Because they go to where there's no sufficient power to keep the sickness away from coming back. Say, I have my church. Then the demon will follow you to the church where he has been enjoying you with your body. I'm telling you. Reality. Those that Jesus healed stayed with him. And one came back one day and said, what? Of 10 of you, Jesus was mindful of that. He said, how many did I heal? He said, 10. Why? He said, one. He said, all that have gone. He said, why? Because you came back, you are made whole.
Yes.
Your case is permanent. They don't go and sneak come back. You came back, you are made whole. That's the difference between power ministry. So when they go back to a talking pastor, the demon come back and say, welcome back. This home for you. We can continue. And then he will not come back alone. He will come back with 7 more top-hat demons. Because he does not want to be chased out easily again. So he's going to connect with more stronger demons. So that when they say, come, I say, no way. We are here. We are legions. I mean, look, ask any healing by Benny Hinn, all those great men of God, they will tell you this one thing. I prayed, I've never had a thought. I prayed one day, I said, how come people get in a crusade ground and then the sickness come back after some months? What is happening? And God said, he said, boy, you want to know mysteries? He said, these people go back to habits or situations that allows those demons to come back naturally. And when they are coming back full force. So they keep doing deliverance back to back and the deliverance is not getting through because the demon had increased. He said the end is usually worse than the beginning. And these are what many Christians don't understand. A pastor came to preach from one village, one city in Nigeria, came to another city to preach, and he removed his suit and gave it to a choir master. Who sang in that crusade? The guy was gifted, very good, dangerous brother. And then that was the end of his ministry. The end of this choir master that was anointed. That was the end of his calling. Wearing the suit of that man. That man had all kind of demon tormenting him. Yet he was a preacher. I can't tell you the detail. I mean, this one I saw live and direct. I know. Finished it. Who you listen to increases you or diminishes you. You come here, you take power anointing message, you go back to home and say, there is no need for you praying. No more days of miracle. Miracles are over. Those old pastors are magicians. You lose your faith again. Gone. And you are trying to grow. You know why he said that? He knows he doesn't have the gift, and he doesn't want you to exhibit the gift of God in your life so that you do not appear to be like a champion in the church. Says, that's you want to prophesy. He says, shut up, don't prophesy here. We don't prophesy here. You want to speak in tongues? Don't speak in tongues. We don't speak in tongues here. Because he does not have the gift, and he does not want you to show the gift.
Yes, true. It's true. It's true.
Keep playing church until church play you out of heaven. Many Christians are just playing church, game of church. I'm a Catholic forever for life. And if the person is coming to Pentecost, I say, I'm a Catholic for life. You don't know what you are doing. Please go back and serve an idol. It's better. Now to say I'm a Catholic for life, I'm just coming to this church anyway. I like that's why I just like you. But I'm a Catholic for life. Please go back to idol worship. Because it's even worse. The religion is unstable. You can't afford to be empty. Lift up your right hand and say, Lord, every emptiness in me, let the Holy Ghost fill it up now. Say it again. Say, Lord, every emptiness in me, let the Holy Ghost fill it up right now. In the name of Jesus. That's why when you watch horror film, you experience horror dreams. Right? So, what do you play in your car? Do you have CDs of messages of good preachers in your car? What do you listen to? You know, in your car, in your place of work? Your headset, what are you listening to? Listen to good messages. Listen to pastors that can inspire you in the direction of your gift. There's a woman of God who is preaching powerfully and highly anointed. Listen to her more often. People like Catherine Kuma who can come and say, Holy Spirit, an anointing is just moving. Yes. By the time you come out, you're a different person. Well, this is a pastor just talking, like he's in a lecture room. We went to one church, they finished serving, didn't know, we were still waiting for anointing to flow. And the people started going with their buses outside. I said, my wife, the service is already saved.
Ah.
It's packed. Eh? Packed full. See your manner of dressing like in a clubhouse. I said, what? Is this church? I was waiting for something to happen. If I man that kind of auditorium, miracle must happen.
Amen.
I mean, where there is crap, the more the crap, the more demons to cast out.
Yes.
The more healing that can take place. And the pastor just talked and just told us Bible story of Jesus went to fetch water and the woman didn't give me water to drink. And he said, the woman said, you don't know me. If you know me, you would have given me water. And he told the story and then he said, you're coming here for the first time. We would like to identify with you again. And then they played beautiful music. And then people came out and then I said, go away. Sit down. Let's enjoy this music first. And then when the music finished, and then people started going out, say, like that. No prayer, not blessing of release for the week. Like that. I said, what? We are not coming back here. What you hear influences you. Please write that down. What you hear influences you. What you hear, do what?
Influence.
When you are gisting with your friend, 4 hours is not enough. How many of you know that?
Yeah.
But there are times you want to hear the truth. 30 minutes, you're already tired. The devil will make it happen like that you cannot stand 30 minutes to hear the truth that will benefit you. But 4 hours to play around with your friend, if you see, so fast. Oh, I wish the time can be extended, you know. What you hear influences you. I've said enough on this subject. The area of grow in the word of God. I said grow in faith, grow in faith, grow in faith, number one. I said grow where? In grace. And number three, grow in the word of God. You know that for yourself, you know. The word of God is the spirit food for the spirit man. That's why you must grow in the word of God. The word of God is the spirit food for the spirit man. How do you grow in the word of God? Continue in the word. John chapter 6, verse 26 to 29. John 6, 26 to 29. Continue in the word. Jesus said, if you continue or abide in my word, then are ye my disciples. If you continue and abide in my word, then are ye my disciples. John chapter 8, verse 31 to 22. Indeed, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Why do you need to stay on the word of God? Because it exposes your spirit man to sweet divinity, to secrets of divinity. I mean to say, the word of God exposes your spirit man to secrets of divinity. The more word of God you are exposed to, the more power you generate from your spirit man. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Stand up now and say, and stretch yourself and say, Lord, I receive now,
Lord, I receive now
the ability to grow,
the ability to grow
and be matured
in the name of Jesus.
You remember where we started us teaching from, right? You remember the text we read? We read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11, where he says there's a time to be a child, there's a time to become an adult. You know, there's a time when I was a child, I speak like a child. When I was an adult, I speak like an adult. You just need to grow. We need to grow. There are things we cannot say as adults, right? There are things that children can say. And today's children, they are even wiser than adults of yesterday. They are smart, smarter than adults of yesterday. Because of growth, these kids, they are growing faster than their age. A little girl was sitting with her father and they were playing in the living room, just chatting, playing. And then the mom came back from work. And the baby said, Mom, how was your day? And the mom just went into the room. And the girl turned back to her and said, Dad, where did you get her from? You not like this? You talk, you play with me. She doesn't just flow. We don't just connect. That's today's kids. This one is strange. When we are younger, we can't talk like that.
Never.
They will conk your head and until
you
slap your mouth.
Say, Mom, Dad, where did you get this one from? She is strange. Mom is weird. See, you're not like that. You talk, you play with me, you spend time. Mom, that's today's kids. They are deep in mind, deep. What runs in their mind is deep. At their age. And that's why we cannot afford to remain a child, because today's kids, they are growing on a daily basis. They will outrun you if you don't grow. Why I try to grow more in grace every day in my ministry, even back home, is I don't want the pastor I'm raising up to overrun me.
Amen.
I'm working out on a daily basis to increase. It's beautiful for a child to be bigger than you, but don't become too big and become redundant. And become a problem to the child. Pray one prayer, 1 minute, and say, Lord,
Lord,
I receive the anointing to grow.
I receive the anointing to
grow. In the name of Jesus. Pray that prayer right now. Power to grow. Grace to grow. Please lift up your voice.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Power to grow in grace, in wisdom, in faith, in the world. I receive it, Lord. Marava Shantarava. The anointing to grow in spirit. Let it come upon me. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Can I hear a louder amen?
Amen?
A bigger amen?
Amen?
A stronger, powerful amen?
Amen?
Another sign of growth, it's we show in your prayer life. Grow your prayer life. You see, there's a way I used to pray when I was younger. There's a way I pray now that I'm growing. I'm still, I don't want to say I've grown up. I'm still growing. There's a way in which I'm growing on a daily basis in my spiritual work, in my prayer life. There are days that, in those days, as I was growing, I need to shout and buck the air to know that, and sweat all energy, then I know that I've prayed. Those bodily exercise is good. But it profits little. No, little. It's still profit, but little. But there's a way you grow up, you just feel like this. When you stand up, the devil is running away.
Amen.
Which one is better? The one you just
see.
Yes. Yeah, that's better.
You just look. You just, 1 second is sufficient. You just can't through the matter in the spirit. And that the one you have to box the devil. Bring out your gun, let's fire the devil. Every devil from my father's house, go! Every, and you are not shooting nothing. You are just exercising your muscles.
It's true.
That's the reality. We pastor, we do all kind of things to make people wake up from sleeping.
It's true.
The pastor don't pray like that. He knows. He knows what to do. But he won't teach you that because he wants to keep you as a baby.
Yeah. Year to
keep depending on him. If you call me for 2 years and you don't stop calling me for prayer points, I will cut off from you. Because after 2 years, I expect you to know how to handle sentiment. When you call me, I call you, oh, pastor, oh, I just had some major breakthrough. I'm coming to share the testimony. That's better. Don't call me for, after 2 years, you're still calling for, pastor, my headache. You still have headache of 2 years? Keep it. I'm tired of praying for that headache. I expect you to have grown out of that level of headache. Talk about another thing. Let's deal with that one. Because as I pray with you, I'm showing you the secret of how to handle certain matter. I expect you to learn the process. Shout, I am growing up!
I am growing up!
I didn't say it, I said shout it.
I am growing up!
We are not in the church, we are in the school. Say, shout, I am
growing up!
Growing up!
Growing up!
Now!
Growth!
Is part of me.
It's part of me.
On a daily basis.
On a daily basis.
Say it one more time, growing up!
I'm growing up!
Now!
Growth!
It's part of me.
It's part of me.
What can I say? I'm growing up.
I'm growing up.
I am growing up.
I'm growing up.
I'm getting better.
I'm getting better.
On a daily basis. In the name of Jesus. Spiritually. Mentally. Academically. Socially.
Socially.
I am growing up.
I am growing up.
Better and better.
Better and better.
On a daily basis.
On a daily basis.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
That confession is powerful. Keep it to your heart and walk on them. Amen.
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 Sit down. My intention today was to wrap up the two major subjects for this month, but I'm unable to do that. But who is blessed today? Now, any question? Any question? Anything that I said that confused you or that threw you out of balance? Or I said something that I think is not in the Word of God. You can challenge it. It's cool. You know, in the regular church, we preach some messages and you're unable to ask questions about it. You just say, okay, Pastor said it, but I don't know. Maybe it's like that already. In a school of ministry like this, you can ask. My intention at the end of this school for you is you're a better person.
Amen.
Spiritually,
amen.
Mentally,
amen.
Socially.
Amen.
If your amen is not that, you are doing
nothing. Amen.
Your ability to say amen in service is a sign of growth. Americans don't say amen. Americans say okay. They are praying for them. They are saying okay. They need deliverance. One of the key things that we teach in our ministry. That I wanted to teach today is also on the subject of humility. And we'll deal on that subject in the next class. There's something that the Lord taught me this morning that I added that subject into it, that matter into it. On the subject of consistency for you to grow in power, grace, virtue, your walk with God. And these are some of the areas we touch in this court ministry to prepare us for. They are things that are like elementary for me teachings before we go into deep matters of things of the spirit. Because like I said, God will not commit serious things into the hand of babies. God is watching us, he's watching you, he's watching, can she undo this? If I show him this secret, can he undo it? To cast out madness, there's a secret to casting out mad spirit. There's a secret to access breakthrough. Everything has secret code. There's secret to a successful ministry. Successful ministry is not determined by the number of people you have, or large congregation, or big car you have. It's not measured by your fame or popularity. Jesus said, he will say to me on the last day, I cast that devil in your name, I healed the sick, I cast that, you know, I did that, all miracles in your name. He said, you workers of iniquity, I knew it not. You're able to do all kind of miracles yet. Their work didn't pass the test of heaven. So there are secrets to doing this work and still maintain eternity. Because we will not be here forever. Heaven is our focus, right?
We
will not be here forever. We will not be here forever. So, these are some of the secrets we want to teach us in this ministry. And I'm cautioning myself because I'm trying to even find out who can undo this, who cannot undo this. Can I separate the class at one point? But I'm watching and praying that God will make you grow to that realm to be able to assess all the secrets of the kingdom and to be able to fulfill your own primary assignment on earth. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You must fulfill your primary assignment. That is what will qualify you for a welcoming home at eternity. If you fail your assignment, you lose everything. You lose your world. Understand it. That all of these efforts coming to church, preaching, casting out devil, ends at one thing. Reward. on the last day. So if you are doing the work or you are doing somebody else's work, there is no reward for you. You have to do your work. The pastor says service starts 7 and you are coming 8 o'clock. There is a reward. Because it's a sign of maturity. Some people cannot listen to a message of 40 minutes. They are tired already. They will be sleeping. They cannot handle 40 minutes when they are tired. But 4 hours gisting and gossiping. Oh my God. There is an anointing for it. You need to grow. You have been in church for too long to play around now. Please tell that to your neighbor. You have been in church for too long. You need to come up a little more. So that people around you can see and say, okay, something has changed about this woman. Something has changed. So I told one young man in my office, I said, she was there, I said, I want your parents to see you in 6 months from here. I said, since you've been going to that apostles' church, there's something about you that has changed. Don't just come play drum and walk away. The father should see you, or my son, oh, he's doing well. Not just academically, no, but he's also doing morally, doing well. He's doing well financially. He's managing his finances. We told him, get an account, run this. You said things that your father will say, wow, who is teaching you this? Let it be the result of right teaching. There are things that every teacher is looking for in their student. There's thing I'm looking at to see in your life in 1 year from here. That I will sit down like this someday and you are casting out manner of devils. And I say, wow. That's the joy of every father. It will happen in your life.
Amen.
You will do greater than your fathers.
Amen.
I say you will do greater than your fathers.
Amen.
I said you will do greater than your fathers.
Amen.
Pastor, if you tell them you cast out a devil, they will, from that day they will not allow you to pray any prayer again. That's the last prayer you ever pray. See, you pray, somebody got healed. Pastor went to visit somebody and then she was sick. We just lay hand in the person. You tell your partner, and say, oh really? Please don't go on visitation again. I have something for you to be You will think he's promoting, he's already engaging you. This one, the way you are going, you know, please, there's something, you'll be doing administration work now. There's something you need to be doing. You know, you are too special. I don't want to be going out too much. You know? Some people will not look too familiar with you. He will package you in a way that you say, yes, my pastor loves me. But he's keeping you, killing you.
Killing me softly.
Oh, don't make me remember 1980s. How many of you really want to grow? This 1 year, may growth happen in your life.
Amen.
And this is why you cannot afford these teachings for ministry. You can reap. We will make everything available for you to grow. My son back home brought all manners of. 1 year, we say, give him a car. Caster, devil, do man, the things he could not do before. Dangerous. I said, that is my boy. That is my boy. Now I'm looking for a good wife for him. Highly anointed woman that when she sings or move body like this, everything shake. Hey! Okay, I'll take it to Nigeria. Promise it is there. Grow. It's beautiful when you see your children grow. And they are doing well in life and ministry. It's beautiful. So please grow. Who enjoys it more? You. Before your teacher enjoys your growth, you enjoy it. Like my boy, people give one man of gift because he's growing. If he misbehaves, he will not have any reward. People give him one man of gift, buys him gift, give him stuff. It's growing. You can trust him as a leader now. You can look up to him and say, this is a father in the house. Growth. They will not call him father before. Now they call him father. Growth. I have people who were like 80 something, 90 in my church back in those days. They will kneel down to daddy, daddy, say, me, daddy, I'm raised my say, daddy, our father. I say, hey, see my life. How beautiful it is for old woman to honor you. Growth. When you grow, you enjoy more. People celebrate you, your life becomes more easy. Throw away those little anger, those little attitude, those little annoyance, those talk. Grow up. Come to church smiling, love the people, laugh, hug the people if they are huggable, shake them if they are shakeable, because everybody's not huggable. So hug when they are huggable, shake when they are shakeable, eye if they are highable, smile. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't come to church every day, you are frowning. You are not growing. You are not the person that have the worst problem on earth. Smile. Forget what is happening in your life. Because your frowning face will kill the anointing even of the pastor. When you frown too much, you can kill the anointing of the pastor. How many of you know?
Yes.
When I'm preaching, there are people I don't want to look into their face, because when you look, the anointing drop. You have to blow it up. Say, Lord, help me. Lord, I don't want to fall yet. Because their face is killing the anointing. Nothing touch them, nothing move them. Shout at yourself. Why are we shouting again? Everything kills. This is nothing move them. Give offering, they will not give. Nothing move them. Please, grow up. Is that enough now?
Yes.
Grow up. With emphasis, grow up. Come on, shout, let your neighbor hear that now.
Grow up.
Say it to him if his face is not scary.
Grow up.
I don't used to preach like this, close my eyes. It's people that make me to be close my eyes. I'm telling you. The people told me in my church, they said it was an anointing.
It's an anointing, yeah.
I'm telling you, it wasn't an anointing that led to that. I'm telling you the truth. The people thought it was that when he closed eyes, he's trying to see something. <It's people. laughs> I preached in that church for 2 years. One church, I was part of that church. They almost killed the anointing. So I closed my eyes, preach path, because when you are preaching, you will see like they want to stone you. Some say, like, pastor, fall and die now. So I close my eyes, I preach powerful message. When I finish, I run to my office. Before I know it, my eyes became closed. I'm trying to open it back now. May God open my eyes again.
Amen.
But of course, I turned it for my good, to my favor, and I began to direct it to favor me, you know, to meditate more. But I didn't start like that. I used to preach wide open. I even see more when I'm speaking to your face. I have this prayer for you as we go tonight. And that prayer is that the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit that raised up Christ from the grave, will rest upon your body.
Amen.
If you can kneel down for 1 minute to pray that prayer, the Spirit that raised up Christ from the grave. That's the impartation part of this school of ministry. Now you are. The angel just signaled that he is ready now. Now you have opportunity to connect. The Spirit that raised up Christ from the grave is a living Spirit. Let it come upon me. Talk to the Lord.